I want to give you the description of the fivefold ministry when it is in Babylon described. I sense power. It's our power. There's too much power. Maybe I want to be the Bible for the first time. So this morning, somebody shout power.
Power.
You know, in the days of Jesus, the Bible says the power of the Lord was present to heal.
Amen.
Power is present.
Come on.
You will receive power when
the Holy Ghost comes.
Some translation says after the Holy Ghost.
Ah.
Don't worry, we are living in Joel chapter 2.
Yeah.
Afterwards.
Yeah.
Yes, the afterwards generation. That this is their generation. We are not trying to appropriate it. We have already received it.
Uh-huh.
It's a done deal, the Holy Ghost. Serious. Come on now. I believe in the power of God. I believe. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, imagine. You see, now we're under the power. We still are making change. You are going under. You are nice, Jesus. Psalms 137. By the rivers of Babylon. And we sat down here, yeah, we wept when we remembered Zion. So there are two systems here. There is a Babylon system and there is a Zion system. You see, Zion can't sing in Babylon. Because faith has no song when fellowship is broken.
Yes.
We are going back to the Father, né? Relationship restored. But we can't sing the Lord's song in a strange land. I mean, we can't keep silent when the church of the living God is not what God has designed it to be. We can't keep silent when people are lying on the pulpit. We can't. Because we know what Zion looks like. So by the rivers of Babylon, the river of Babylon is counteracted by three rivers. A river from the throne, a river from the belly, and a river from the temple. Let me read. We hand our harps upon the willows in the midst thereof. For they that carried us away captive required of us a song, and they that wasted us requires us a mirth, saying, sing us one of the songs of Zion. Verse 4. How shall we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? Verse 5. If I forget thee, O Jerusalem, let my right hand forget her cunning. If I do not remember thee, let thy tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth. If I prefer not Jerusalem upon my chief joy. Verse 7. Remember, O Lord, the children of Edom. This is Esau, ne? This is also Oba, the Dom. In the day of Jerusalem, who said, Russet even in the foundation thereof. O daughter of Babylon, who art thou to be destroyed. Happy he be that reneweth thee as thou hast sent us. Happy shall he be that take away the dashed little ones against the stone. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I go to the book of Ezra. And let's reveal the dilemma here. Can you say, I'm not afraid anymore?
I'm not afraid anymore.
Lelo ikhulu elam lokuz encourage. Oh, I said Ezra. Chapter 1, can you see that? Thank God for Cyrus. Thank God for the prophecy of Isaiah. After 70 years of captivity, 70 plus years. Now in the days of Cyrus, the king of Persia, the word of the Lord by the mouth of Jeremiah might be fulfilled. The Lord stirred up the spirit of Cyrus, the king of Persia, that he made a proclamation throughout the kingdoms and put it also in writing, saying, and this is a decree, ne? So when the king says a decree, it cannot be reversed. Amen. It can only be counteracted by another one. Thus says Cyrus, the king of Persia, the Lord God of heaven. So these people were not released by Cyrus. They were released by the Lord. Thus says Cyrus, the king of Persia, the Lord God of heaven had given me all the kingdoms of the earth, and he had charged me to build him a house at Jerusalem, which is in Judah. Who is there among you of all the people? And remember, these are the descendants of the children of Israel that were in captivity. Some, their elders actually died there. 70 years of captivity. So the king is asking, who is there among you, all these people? His God be with him, and let him go up to Jerusalem, which is in Judah, build the house of the Lord of Israel. He is the God which is in Jerusalem, and whosoever remaineth in any place where he sojourneth, let the men of his place help him with silver. Can you all say silver?
Silver.
With gold, can you say gold?
Gold.
With goods, can you say goods?
Goods.
With beasts, can you say beast?
Yes.
And then it says, besides the free will offering of the house of the Lord in Jerusalem. And then from verse 5, I just want to indicate the group of people out of the 12 tribes, the group of people who took the journey out of obedience when the king spoke a release. Then rose up the chief of the fathers of Judah. Can you say Judah?
Judah.
And Benjamin. Can you say Benjamin?
Benjamin.
Now, two tribes that we see here, Judah and Benjamin. This is a problem indeed. And the Levites, that is a third tribe. Praise the Lord. But I don't necessarily want to focus on the Levite, because I will tell you their concern pertaining to the land. To go and build the house of the Lord, which is in Jerusalem. So, of course, Judah and Benjamin can't build God's house without Levi. They cannot. Praise the Lord. So as much as Judah has strength on his own, the strength of a lion, Benjamin having the strength of a wolf, praise the Lord, they do not have the grace to build God's house apart from Levi. I'm going to read the last verse. I'm already preaching already. This is like Revelation. The church at Laodicea. We'll see it just now. Chapter 3, verse 17. afraid anymore. I'm not afraid anymore. Verse 17. Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased in goods. And have need of nothing, and thou knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable and poor and blind and naked. Now five things, ne? One, wretched. Two, miserable. Three, poor. Four, blind. Five, that is the picture of the fivefold ministry in Babylon. We may be seated in the presence of the Lord.
Be seated, please.
Okay, this is history. And I want to believe that we ought to understand this history accurately. So, amen. Okay, one more verse. Chapter 2, verse 16. Hey, Maru, we live in sometimes. Okay, we're gonna search chapter 2, verse 14, and then chapter 2, verse 61 and 62.
Revelation.
And 63.
Revelation.
Are we on Revelation. Ezra 2:14.
Oh, Ezra.
Mamela Gina. The Levites of the children of Jeshua and Katliel of the children of Hodaviah, 70 and 4. Can you say 70 and 4?
70 and 4.
You see, this is a small number of the priests. When you look at the register of those who returned, right? But let's reveal a problem concerning these priests. 61. And of the children of the priests, the children of Habiah, the children of Koz, the children of Barzillai, which took the wife of the daughters of Barzillai, the Gileadite, and was called after their name. This is a problem again. You see, there were priests who married the daughters of the Gileadites, and here's the worst thing that happened to those priests. They took the name of the priests. The priests took the name of the daughters. Now I'm preached to a man. And guess what happened? Now they have returned. Now Zerubbabel is bringing forth the register. In the 74 priests that are there, these ones, when they were looking for them in the register, they were not found. 62. These sought their register among those that were reckoned by genealogy. Kumbulene, the priesthood that is dominant is the priesthood of Aaron. So you are only a priest if you are from Levi, and you are only a priest if your record is found within the priestly lineage. But they were not found, therefore, were they as polluted from the priesthood. Ngenxa yokuthi bachinja amasenemu abo. It means they forfeited their birthright by intermarrying. They also polluted the priesthood. So when they checked on the register, they say these people are no longer qualified to be as priests. So the register disqualifies them. But then, Tishata, which is actually the Zerubbabel, or rather the word for governor, It is the Persian name for governor. Said unto them, and this is Zerubbabel, that they should not eat of the most holy things till there stood a priest with the Urim and the Thummim. Can you say the Urim?
Urim.
Lights. Can you say the Thummim?
Thummim.
Perfections. And I want to tell you this. This generation operates on a higher level than the Urim and the Thummim. The prophetic office is higher when compared to the Urim and the Thummim. Because the prophetic is the mouth. The Thummim is of discernment. You have to use gemstones to determine the will of God. But on this one, on the prophet, God just speak plainly, not through a dream, face to face. He tells you your business. And these are two gemstones that were hidden somewhere in the pocket of the priest behind the breastplate, signifying that God says the 12 tribes ought to receive spiritual guidance. They must be guided. God have mercy. Let's pray. Father God, you are lovely. And Heavenly Father, you are special. You are worthy to be praised. We come before you as sons and daughters. We pray for the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you, that the eyes of understanding may be enlightened. In Jesus' name. And everybody say amen.
Amen.
Okay. By the rivers of Babylon, we sat down and we wept when we remember what? Zion. Of course, this is addressing the Israelites that are taken into captivity. And the result of the captivity is only one thing, disobedience and failure to hearken to prophetic voices in their time. It's like Jeremiah has been prophesying to these people. Habakkuk is the last prophet of Judah who gave forth the warning concerning these things. And Habakkuk was more of a dialogue prophet, kind of. He was busy praying concerning the injustices in the land. And he was actually saying to God, why are you not judging the injustice in the land? And unfortunately, when God responded, the prophet did not like the Lord's answer. Because the Lord's answer was that, I am going to bring a nation that is more evil to judge a nation that is less evil. And the prophet said, never, you can't do that. And the prophet had a dialogue with God concerning that, to say, how could you say you are a God of justice if you do that? And God said, don't worry, I will give you a vision, I will give you an answer. In fact, in chapter 2, Habakkuk receives 7 curses for the very nation that will judge the nation that has greater evil, that will judge a nation that has less evil, which is Babylon. So God was saying, imagine, I'm asking God, please judge this nation. And God says, I'm going to bring the Babylons who are more evil to judge the ones that are less evil. And that confounded the prophet. That actually made the prophet to say, this is not just. And God responded to the prophet by saying, don't worry, it is actually me trying to set up Babylon for punishment. I need them to touch my anointed one so that I can touch them. I have no reason to touch them because they are ungodly, very. But in order for me to touch them, they must be the godly one. Maybe I should remind you also about that, because God cannot punish Sodom and Gomorrah unless Lot is there. It was Lot that actually ensured that the judgment of Sodom and Gomorrah prevails. If Lot was not there, there was no reason for God to see the distinctions, because these people are evil already. You see, the problem why God will bring the judgment is because there's a righteous one in our midst. Righteousness says, let sin be judged. So, Babylon, what is it? That land, Sodom and Gomorrah, is as evil as any other people, but they are evil was seen when the righteous one was in their midst. And as a result, the Lord says, if they touch him, I touch them. Of course, the verse that says, touch not my anointed ones and do my prophets no harm. It is not only limited to prophets. It is a verse that is touching the whole house, because the whole house is anointed. He that touches you touches the apple of God's eye. You are as special as any other person in the body because you were born with the precious blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus had to go through that terrible death in order to purchase you and to redeem you, such that you are no longer just called a Gentile anymore. You are now called a son of the living God. So, see, I'm going to judge these people. Don't worry. When Babylon touches Israel, I will have the reason to touch Babylon. And then he begins to release the woes over them, the judgments over them. And these judgments were actually the punishment of the sins of Babylon, because Babylon was described. God began to judge Babylon strongly on the basis of their sins. And God is good in doing that. Amen. And I know we are living also in a generation that believes that there's no judgment anymore. Say amen.
Amen.
And that must be preached in its proper what? Context. And what does Peter mean under grace when he said, for judgment will begin in the house of the Lord. And of course we need to understand what judgment is, because the book of John describes why God brings judgment through the Holy Spirit. And I want you to understand also matters regarding conviction, but that is not the subject matter. The issue here is that the church was carried over to Babylon because of disobedience. This is Israel taken to Babylon because of disobedience. And Jeremiah prophesied 7 years. Some false prophets also emerge and say, our God is so good. He's full of grace. He can't judge us. Remember, he's a God of grace. He can't do this to us. He loves us so much that he can't punish us. And only to find out that the true prophet Jeremiah has already prophesied a sure word of prophecy. Now people with itching ears supported their own prophets, who are actually saying it's fine to have license, live the way you want to live, because our God is a God of grace. I don't like this greasy grace that has been preached in our season. Because the truth of the matter is that the grace of God teaches a believer to say no to ungodliness. Listen, if grace I vumeli ukuthuhlale
sonweni,
I gain permission ukuthuhlale sonweni, if grace yenza uncomfortable, if grace says sin has no dominion over you because you are no longer under the law, you are under what? When grace looks at sin, it says it's a done deal, it is finished, somebody suffered on your behalf. You can't be still going through that when I have already done and dealt with that fully so on the cross. So the penalty of sin was paid by Jesus Christ of Nazareth on the cross. God have mercy on this generation. So now, I want to show you what happened. They went to Babylon. God promised that he will judge Babylon.
Mm-hmm.
But Babylon had overcome the Israelites. God sent Media Persia to overcome Nebuchadnezzar and Babylon. So Babylon was also judged. And now the whole region is now Media Persia. So Media Persia, King Cyrus is actually from Media Persia. But these are many years. So God was true through the mouth of Habakkuk in indicating that he will also judge those people that will judge his people. So God is true on his word. And now Cyrus stands in that generation now. And this is what he's saying. And this is the obedience of the prophecy of Isaiah. And when Cyrus stood, he declared that the God of heaven had commanded him to go and build a house in Babylon. And this is where the problem is. The king released a decree to say, wonke umuntu waka Israel ofila ukuthi anga unokhono, or whom the Lord has set up in the heart. In other words, he was not commanding everyone to go, because Abanaba, they already had children there. Jeremiah had already said that I know the plans I have for you. You are staying in Babylon, not in Zion. And to build houses, have wives. So these people have already had children. They already have families. They are now comfortable in a strange land. And now the king comes and says, I have a command to bring restoration over the Israelites. Let everyone who is stirred in the heart go back home. And guess what? Zerubbabel, meaning the one born in Babylon, is the one who is leading this group of people. Now you are coming out of captivity, but the road from Media Persia back to Babylon is a long route. It means you have to pack up your life and leave. You have to leave whatever establishment you have and leave. And as a result, only 15,000 people obeyed. In fact, the calculation is something like 43,000 people obeyed. And in the 43,000 people who obeyed, only four sets of priests, which was according to the order of David, 24. Only four in the order of priests obeyed. Now, this is the problem. And then the two tribes that obeyed, we are not going to count the other tribes. The two tribes that obeyed is the tribe of Judah. Say Judah.
Judah.
So Judah moved. Benjamin moved. Levi moved. But when Levi came back, Levi was no longer in his strength in terms of numbers. What does this mean to me and you? The decree of Cyrus is come out of Babylon. Unfortunately, the church today, the Lord is saying to you, come out of Babylon, but not all of us are obeying.
Mm-hmm.
We are not obeying because the voice of the king says, come out of here. And we are not all coming out of here because we still have now benefits in Babylon. We have establishments in Babylon. We've got buildings in Babylon, investments in Babylon. We are still married to the world system.
Hey.
And not everyone wants to come out. That is why among the 24 priests, 20 of them against the four that are speaking the truth. Four sets of priesthood are willing to pay the price of building God a house. In other words, they are saying, I do not care about my building. I do not care about my name. I do not care about my empire. All I want to build is to build the house of the Lord. But unfortunately, the 20 well-established priests in Babylon have now become your enemy. From the 20, only 4 returned. It's an embarrassment. The command is that you will have resources. Take silver, take gold, take goods, all that you need. In fact, letters were given to them. Go to the treasuries, open up, let everything be restored. But let me tell you this. In the restoration of what God is doing in this season, the temple furniture is restored, but the people are the ones who do not want to take part in the restoration. What am I trying to say? The presence of God through the cross restored. The anointing through the cross restored. The power through the cross restored. Wealth through the cross restored. But the children of God, they are the ones who are surrendering from the call. Because the journey is too long and risky. You are going to have to pass through the enemies of Samaria. You are going to, the journey is dangerous. You are not an army of Israel. You are just a tribe going back home. So on the road, there are tough things. That is why persecution is the order of the day. But nevertheless, our God is not the God of numbers. With a few people, a remnant that obeys the Lord, he will still build the house.
Yes.
I pray that you don't die in Babylon. I pray that you don't die trying to please men. I pray that you don't die compromising the word. I pray that you don't die doing things and singing songs that you are not supposed to be singing. Because people are still singing songs of the Lord in a strange land. That song is not making any impact. If you want to sing the Lord's song, build Jerusalem first. Restore relationship first. Because this thing that you call even gospel is not gospel. Because a gospel song is a song that must testify concerning the birth, the resurrection, the death, and the burial of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Then that is a gospel song. It's a song that proclaims the work of the cross and proclaims what Jesus has done on the cross.
Yeah.
So you are not a gospel artist if you are not born again. So we must not allow these people to sing for us, because we cannot allow them to sing a Lord's song while they are still in a strange land. They are not anointed to sing for us. So we are not going So we rather have our own sisters and brothers sing unto the Lord. They might be vocally wounded, but when they sing, they are opening the heavens. Say Babylon. So only four sets of priests returned. And in the return of the four sets of priests, this is the situation I want to describe, which is the second problem on the matter there. Is that some of the priests in verse 16, they married the daughters and took the name of the daughters. Chapter 1 of Ezra, one message. Come out of here. Get out of Babylon. Chapter 2 of Ezra, the register. Know who you are in Christ. So people are mentioned according to their tribes, according to their register, according to the manner or the lineage. You must know who you are. You must not take the place that you are not anointed for, because you're going to mess things up. And then the Bible says, these guys, when they were checked on the register, these are priests, they were considered as polluted. In other words, by changing their names, they were actually selling with their birthright. They traded. I would rather have a Babylonian woman rather than be a minister of the gospel. I would rather have this deal than rather be the minister of the gospel. I would rather embrace this lie rather than speak the truth. I would rather sign with the truth rather than suffer for the truth. So they made an exchange. Now the question is, in this generation, what we have exchanged the things of God with? Money is the devil. Provision in the church. So not everyone who's preaching the gospel is building Jerusalem. Mm-hmm. Others are building their names, Babel. Hey. Brick and mortar. People are building in order for their names to be known.
Yeah.
It does not work like that, and we can't pretend anymore. The truth will set you free. You lost your birthright. You have polluted the priesthood. You are no longer qualified to be a minister because of the things that you have done. Ah, Jesus said this. Verse 63. The governor said, Angabi nomuntu ozodla ama benefits of the holy things until kuphakama priest with the Urim and the Thummim. Now I can take this to the New Testament. Can you say Aaron?
Aaron.
Say Aaron again.
Aaron.
Say Aaron again.
Aaron.
Aaron, the high priest. Now I'm done. I'm four. Then I was five.
Mm-hmm.
In the fivefold ministry.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Now, but that is what I want to see about Aaron. In one guy Hebrews, he cries out, why the priesthood of Aaron is now disqualified. Now we don't choose the priesthood of Christ after the order of Melchizedek. Can you say Melchizedek?
Melchizedek.
Now I don't know what he has and then what he has got. Sonke na besisezweni. Okay. Uma wethu uSatan. Okay. Insindiso ingakafiki. Manje uJesu, when God raised him up on the cross above any other thing, he was being raised as a priest, dying for the sins of the world, fulfilling priestly duty, fulfilling sonship duty right on the cross. And in my manifestation, lithi akekho umuntu okumele adle izinto ezingwenengwene until kuphakama priest. In Calvary, the priest was raised. Manje na indaba yekelani ukushumayela izinto zaseBhayibhelona. The priest has been raised. Let no one preach another gospel. The priest has been raised. Stop preaching the things of the law and bondage. The priest has been raised. Right now, the priest is introducing the new order. And the new order is that it is a better covenant. It is better hope. He is the better minister. He is greater than angels. He is greater than Aaron. He is even greater than the house. He is even greater than Moses that you love. So this is what we are saying. When the high priest has been raised, let no one eat. Because if we eat, we are all going to eat the things of the past. We are going to participate in old wine skin. We are going to participate in the things that are now rotten in Christ. In Christ, God is calling us to newness of life. So when Christ died 2,000 years ago, the message was now the message has changed. Because now there is a man on the throne who has a ministry. And the ministry that he has is a ministry of reconciliation. It's a ministry without retaliation. It's the ministry of forgiveness. It's the ministry of grace. Better promises. So now you must change your message. You can't eat until the priest stands with the Urim and the Thummim. No one must eat. No one must participate. No one must partake unless the focus is the king. So now in Kimak. In Babylon, I have read the verse from the church in Laodicea. Kutiwa, but we are rich. We are rich. We are lacking nothing. But when the Lord looks at them, he says, no, you are wretched. You are miserable. You are poor. You are blind. And you are what? Now let me tell you why the church has not been growing. It's because wretchedness took the pulpit. And for generations and days, wretchedness was preaching, I am rich, I lack nothing, I am anointed. But that was a sound from Babylon. And then we thought this man was a prophet, but he was miserable, and miserable took the place. And today people are using prophets for personal gains.
Yeah.
And we thought that we are going to receive the ministry of the word. And this man is going to study the scriptures and give us the meat of the word. But when he reached the pulpit, he was naked.
Oh.
And in nakedness, he tried to deliver a message that's about him. So what are we hearing from the pulpit? The church is eating nakedness. The church is eating blindness. The church is eating poorness. No, I don't want to call it poverty. Poorness. So, for years, the people that are supposed to stand as equippers to equip the church, they've been blinding the church. They've been making the church more miserable. They've been making the church more naked. And in the interim, they are dressing themselves. No, I'm talking about the fivefold ministry.
Yes.
And let me tell you why the fivefold ministry is doing this. It's doing this because it has not recognized that nobody must eat unless a priest stands up with the Urim and the Thummim. Now guess what this means? There are people who have claimed that they are called and they are not called. And those are the ones we invite the most. Come on now.
Yes.
Those are the ones who have opportunities the most. Come on now.
Yes.
Those are the ones who have the dollar the most. Hallelujah. Imagine it is described in five ways. You are wretched, miserable. That's why, Futi, when it comes to tithes, you are miserable. What other message? Fathers, you are poor. The covenant of grace, you are naked. Why? Because not everyone, when God said, come out of him, came out. We have not come out of Babylon as a church. And that is why we are not seeing the manifest glory of God in the church as we should see it today. Pumabui. And the first thing that should become our priority is to build a house for the Lord.
Amen.
So I charge you, in the name of Jesus Christ, recommit, dedicate yourself back into God's agenda. Lose your own agenda and serve the Lord. Listen, uNkulunkulu will provide. No, I will get it. He
yes.
will provide. God will not steal from others to benefit you. Mm-hmm. He will provide. So we can raise a generation that does not emphasize the things that are very key in this season of advancing the kingdom of God in this hour. So what am I trying to say? Come out of Babylon, go back to Zion. Go back to the heart for the king. Go back to loving him with all your heart. Go back to serving him in spirit and in truth. Go back to true worship. Nkulumayi worship la, when asinani asinani, what does he understand?
Yes.
What I'm talking about.
He will provide.
Asukele kusystem simthande uNkulunkulu sibuyele kuNkulunkulu and if kukhona into ekumele sibuyele kuye kakhulu umthandazo tell umkhalo wami ukuthi umthandazo
umthandazo
my people who are called by my name
yes
they can humble themselves and pray turn from their wicked ways the Almighty will hear from heaven and heal our land so the healing in the land comes because the people in the land are healed first. How does the healing come?
Yes.
It's my people who are called by my name. One, humility, an attribute of Christ. Turn from their wickedness, repentance. Clean life. Abanye bafuna ukukhuluma holiness, kodwa ikhona.
Khona.
Ikhona holiness.
Ikhona.
And it's a life that we ought to live.
Yes.
By the glory of the Almighty God. So now, as I close, we need to make changes. We need to rededicate our lives back to the King. Mthandu uNkulunkulu bami kabazalwane.
Yeah.
Thandi ngamabela. Ungayenzi lento le fashion. Kube irelationship yakho noNkulunkulu. So we are going back to loving him and serving no other gods. He will provide, don't worry. He provided. My good mama Cyrus. What you know? Silver. Banikeze. Igolide. Banikeze. If you stay on your assignment and stay within the calling of God for your life, he'll make it.
He'll make it. Yes.
Can we stand?
Anymore.